Welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here. Today, I want to show you five of the best free screen recorders. So these screen recorders are going to be no watermark, but they'll range from simple to more complex options, depending on what you want to do with them. So maybe you want to be able to create lessons, how I do, and upload them to YouTube. I'll show you a good one for that. Maybe you want to be able to just record your screen for gameplay and you don't have to worry about time restrictions. Maybe you just want to take a simple screen record of something you're working on to share with other people. So I've picked five of the ones that I really like, five free screen recorders, and those are what I want to share with you today on Teachers Tech. So just to let you know, I don't use one of these free screen recorders for my YouTube videos. What I use is Camtasia. So this is it right here. This actually has the track already, that the clip of my introduction in it, so I can edit all my videos right in Camtasia. Then I can quickly add these effects if I wanted to add like the cursor effect to have it highlighted wherever I want to go, or many of these other ones right through here. But remember, this isn't a free one, but I do have a discount code. I'll put the links to it down below if you're interested in it. But let's start with some of the really good free ones if you don't need to have all these options. So let's start with number five. And this is an incredibly easy screen recorder to use, and it's all online. This is by Apowersoft, and I'll put the link to the description to this so you can click on it and come to right to this page. So what I want to show you is this one right here. It's the start recording, not the download app one. So I'm going to go ahead and just select this, and you get some options right away what you want to record. And notice that you can add an extension here, a Chrome extension that will place it right up top here so you can quickly get to this page. But I'll let you install that if you would like. If you like, just go ahead and add to Chrome. Now, what is it I want to record? Let's say I want to record the screen. I want to record a webcam. And when you select these, you just need to hit allow them to have access here. And system sound will say yes, and will say microphone. Now, I want to point out, I'm going to just hit start recording, and you're going to see it come up and ask me about the microphone here. Hit allow. And then it asked me to select what I want. But the one thing that didn't happen, if this is the first time you're using it, my webcam didn't pop open. So I'm just going to hit cancel, and I'm going to hit refresh and hit start recording again. This time when I click on the webcam, what you're going to notice is that it will pop up, and here it is. And it's just something I noticed in the very first time when I use it. And notice I can drag it around to where I want here. I can change the size of this as well. Now I can record my microphone just like this. And I can go ahead, if I get all the things that I want, hit start recording. And then now, what do I want to record? You could record a Chrome tab, whatever ones are going to be open, it's going to come up, a window. Here's my options, or the entire screen. So if I wanted to record my entire screen, I could select this. If I wanted to make sure the system audio was in there, I could select this little box. I'm going to hit share. And it does the countdown. Notice it's saying if it's longer than 30 minutes that they suggest downloading it and testing out that one. You can go ahead, but I find they're just trying to sell you up to the pro version on it. We're 8 seconds into this video. I can pause it or stop it, but usually what you'd be using is this one down here because if you went away from this window, this is still here. And I can also hide it. So I'm going to hit stop sharing. And just like that, you can see I have my video. If I click on it, minutes that they suggest downloading it and testing out. You can see it has my video in it. It has my voice recorded. And then I have even a few more options. So first of all, if I want to download this, because this is just online, just click these three little dots here and we have download. So I can just go simply download and it downloads it, and I can open it up with a media player of my choice. So if I go ahead and select this, you can see that this will open up.
Just downloading it and testing out that one.
Super easy to use. We have a few more options that we can use over here. I'll just show you this one. If you wanted to trim your videos, it pops open and allows you to, maybe you want to trim things off the beginning or end. What you can do is just drag them to where you want, and then you can start your processing. So I like this one as a free one. This is incredibly easy to use by Apowersoft. left here. If we want to start a new video, just click on this. I go back or install that extension, then you can quickly get back. So test this out if you just want a simple one. Let's move on to number four now. Number four is Loom. So if you need to make a quick video to share with somebody and you actually want to know if they saw it, Loom is great for that. So in the free version, you're allowed to create 5-minute videos. If you're a teacher, you can actually, with your education email, sign up and then you can get up to 45 minutes. But I'm going to go ahead and sign in to mine. I'm just looking at the free one here. I do have an education account as well, but I'm just going to log in with Google. You can see the different ways that you can create it. But once you're in, it works very similar to even the last one I showed you. You can install a Chrome extension. You could download the desktop app if you'd like. But I'm just going to show you how simple this is to use. It saves one that I already recorded in this one from before. But if I wanted to record new here, all I'm going to do is go to new video up here and record a video. You can notice I can even upload video, but I'm going to hit record a video and then the options come up here. So let me click on this one more time here. And this pops up and this is where I can select what I want. I have a circle. You can see I have the webcam working here and I can place this around also. If I want it only screen, camera only, I have those options. I'm just going to leave everything as is. I'm going to hit start recording. This looks very familiar to the last one. It looks the same. I can choose a window option again, hit this one, hit share. And now you get the countdown and it's going to be recording. So I have a few different places I can stop this. I can stop this here or down here. I'm just going to do this quick one here, stop. And it's preparing the Loom. So now if I go back to, I'm just going to go back to home here and go back to my library again. You should see two are in there. This is the one that I just created here. You can see 8 seconds long. I could go ahead and preview this if I click on this and I'll just hit play.
Recording. So I have a few different places I can stop this.
And we have the options here. You can see we have trim clips. If you'd like, you can go ahead and click on that. What I like about this one most is that ability to share. So if I go ahead and copy the link, I can send this to somebody and paste that in. And then when they open it up, I would actually be notified and say someone viewed this or not. And you have a few different things in here. So you can see there's the different reactions. And if you are paying for it or using the education one, you can have those conversations in between. I use this one at work if I need that quick video to show somebody how to do something. And then I copy and send the link over. And then I have this library here. And also in my education one, I can create teams of people. So this is one I like for a quick one to be able to just show those quick how-tos and send it to somebody. And it doesn't take much time to use this at all. Number three is ShareX. So this is open source, completely free, and this is a very powerful program. And in this video, I'm only talking about screen recording, but this can even do more than just screen recording. So I have downloaded this on my computer. I'm using Windows 11, and it's on my taskbar here. I just have it locked in there, so I'm going to open it up. Now, I want to show you right away, if you take a look, these are the hotkeys. And if we were going to use the hotkeys to just screen record, we just would need shift and print screen. And that's how we can stop start it. But we can do this in other ways too. But before we get into that, real quickly, I just want to go to the tools because take a look at all the things this program can do. And it's completely free. You could use this as a video converter. So you can open up a video in one file format and convert it over. So again, this is a free program, open source. Now, before we do any screen recording, I just want to show you the settings and all the different options that you have. So I'm going to go to task settings here. And I'm going to make sure that I'm under screen recorder. And you can take a look at all the different things that you can change in the settings, but I'm just looking at the screen recorder. So we have some options right here, But where I want to go is the screen recording options. Now, if you take a look at this, I could record from my webcam if I wanted to, but I want to record my screen here. So I'm going to leave it here. But if I drop down, you can see where I have some different options to record from. And we have an audio source. So make sure if you're not getting audio, make sure you've selected. I would have to pick what mic I want. So if I'm using my line one here, the MGXU one, and I can also choose these other options. And this is where this program I find gets really powerful over the other ones. Look at all the different video codecs that we have that we can choose from here. You have lots of different options on that one. Same thing with your audio, and you can start adjusting all these settings through here. So this is why I like this program. We don't have our audio and our webcam and screen recording at the same time. And the path, you'll be able to take these videos and put them together in a different editing program after you record it. So let's do a little test here. I'm just gonna go make sure I have everything here. And I'm going to close out of this one. And I'm just going to go close out of this one. I'm going to go to capture up here. And we're going to go to our screen recording, this one. So we could use the shortcut as well. Then all you need to do is pick the area that you want to record. And when you let go, it's starting to record. And take a look at this. We have our stop, abort, and the time here. And if I look at the bottom right-hand corner of my screen, I can see that it's recording here where I can stop recording from this part too. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit stop recording. We got a little sound there. We can just test this out, what we got. And so if I click on it, it gives me...
It's starting to record. And take a look at this. We have our...
And we have options too, where we can show our mouse, also highlight that. Take a look at the different settings that you can click on this one. So this one I like. It's completely free and very powerful if you're looking for a good screen recorder. Number two is Microsoft's Clipchamp. Now, this is more of a video editor, but it has a great screen recorder built in. And again, you can use this all for free. You do have to make an account with this. But after that, you can either use it for free installed on your Windows computer, or you could just use the web version of this. When you log in, it looks exactly the same, and then you could use it on whatever operating system you're working on. So in this case, I'm not going to use the online version on this. I'm just going to move this out of the way. I'm already opened up Clipchamp on my Windows computer, and I just want to point out we have record something here. I like it that we can edit this afterwards in a good video editor for free. So I'm going to hit record something. What do I want to record? Well, in this case, let's go record screen and camera here. And you'll see my webcam gets picked up. My mic is picked up. Everything looks what I want to hear. I'm going to hit just record. It is limited to 30 minutes in this one. What do I want to record? Well, I could go to this one, hit share. And then, so this is what's going to be recording right now. You can see the timer is going to up to 30 minutes here. I'm just going to hit stop. We have 9 seconds.
And then record. So this is what's going to be recording.
Save and exit. Now I could have picked a different screen, so I didn't have that, endless mirror effect inside of it. But what I like about this, notice that it's on two different layers and I can start editing now. So if I go to this and just right click on this and ungroup, so I have the bottom layer and this layer here, and I can do some editing to this very quickly. I could crop the sides so you can see where the camera is larger. I could crop it down. I can even add effects very quickly. So if I have this selected, go over to the filters, and if I scroll down to the bottom, I have all these filters I can add, but there's actually a green screen one towards the bottom here, right here. So if I select this one and I can change the threshold, you can see how I move this around, and now I have this green screen option here. So again, I can make this larger. if I want, move it around in the screen. So this is sort of like Camtasia, what I do with mine. In Camtasia, it is not as powerful as that, but this is one option that I like with this free one because it comes in two different layers. It doesn't combine it where you can't manipulate that option. So if I was going to hit,
you can see the timer's going.
Play, you can see how it is now. And there's some other options in here. I can actually quickly turn, take this and caption this, but I have a different video kind of explaining this, and I'll put the link down below. And I have a different one about video editing with this one too. So if this is something you want to use, I'll make sure you have the resources to learn how to use them. So this is Clipchamp. And if you're all done with your video, you can just go ahead and export. You can see you can go up to 1080 here. So this is a great option for recording your screen. And my number one pick for free screen recorder is OBS Studio. Now, this is open source, cross-platform, and you can have a lot of different settings for it. And not only can you record your screen, you can also stream. But again, I'm just focused on the screen recording on this one. I'm going to open it up on mine right now. I already have it open. And just to give you a quick little lesson of how you set this up in any of these scenes, what you're going to do is you're going to add your sources. So if I want to add my webcam, I would need to go to a video capture device. And as soon as I do that, I'm going to hit OK and pick which one I want. So there I am right there. So I could go through, and this is the right camera. I'm just going to hit OK. So this can be moved around, but I'm not capturing. Now I have to add something else to capture. So what do I want to capture? I'm just going to go back and add. This time I'm going to go and add a display. Let's go display capture right here. So display capture, I'm going to hit OK. And what is it I want to capture? We'll just say the screen right here. So it's going to be my one desktop. So I'm going to hit OK. And I'm going to just size this. And you can see as I can move it around. Notice that I can't see myself, but I can change the order of these. So if I move the video capture to the top, there I am. And really quickly, I have a different video on this where I get in more depth on this OBS tutorial. And I'm going to have a new video come out and kind of explain the streaming and the screen recording as well. So watch for that. But you can add effects to this too, like green screen. So if I go ahead and right click on this and go filters. So all I have to do is go under the video one here. So this is the video down here, and add, what do I need to add? Well, I'm going to add some chroma key here. So I find the chroma key, I add it. And at this time I can go ahead and start to adjust this. So notice as I drag this, how it changes here. So I can go ahead and close this. If I needed to crop this, I could, because I can see a little top, I could add that filter as well. But once you get things all set up, all you're gonna have to do is go start recording. And you can see there's a stop recording. So if I go ahead and stop recording, it lets me know where the video is going to be saved. But there's more settings and everything in this too. So check out the other video that I made about screen recording here, where I go into a lot more depth. But this is my first pick here if you want a great free screen recorder that can do a lot more, and that is OBS Studio. So let me know what you think of these five picks for the best screen recorders. Let me also know what you're using, because I know there's lots of free screen recorders out there, and I'm always interested in trying some more. Just write them down below in the comments. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.